Good morning, sir. This is our mini project presentation on the topic of robotic vacuum using Arduino. This group comprises of three members, me, myself, Alan, this is Hiten, and this is Varad. So we'll start by introduction. Hiten will give the introduction to our project, and we'll just sit on standby.
So the topic of our mini project presentation is robotic vacuum cleaner using Arduino. So we are developing, the main objective of our developing this robotic vacuum cleaner is to help the old age people and to everyone to clean their households. And so majorly we are using an Arduino board in this and ultrasonic sensor and floor sensor to detect the floor. Now as I told you about the project and its uses, now Alan will continue. And he will tell you about the code explanation and the circuit diagram.
Explaining the program as well as the circuit diagram. So, as we can see, first we are initializing all the pin pinouts which will be connected to the Arduino. So, as we can see, trigger pin 1, echo pin, trigger pin 2, and so on. As we are using 3 ultrasonic sensors, so we will be having 3 trigger pins as well as 3 echo pins. So, we are initializing the pinouts which will be 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, and 11. Should be connected over here. So we are also using an IR sensor. For that we are connecting it to pinout number 2 in the Pro Mini. So we have now defined the variables which will be used for calculating the distance gathered from the ultrasonic sensor as well as from the IR sensor. Initially for the IR sensor we are initializing A equal to 0. I'll let you know in a short while why we are initializing such. And for the ultrasonic, we are first calculating the distance. So we'll be having, we won't be calculating distance, we'll have to find it using the formula. As we can only calculate the duration, that is the time it takes for the ultrasonic wave to reflect back. So we are initializing 3 of them. And we are using it using the long function. And for the distance, we are using it. So we go forward. So we have pin long. We are using pin mode. This will be for initializing whether it's an input or an output. So for the trigger pins, we are using it as output. And for the echo pin, we are using it as input. Because from the trigger, it will send a high signal in which the ultrasonic sensor will be sending a wave. The input will be gained from the echo pins which are connected from probing into the ultrasonic sensor. Okay. So for the IR pin, we are using it as input. And for the motor connections, we are using pin number 4, 7, 8, and 12. All of them are output because we are connecting it to a motor. Further, it will be instructed whether it's an output or an input. And then we are using digital write. To send a low signal to trigger pin 1, which is connected to the IR ultrasonic sensors. This will be for 2 microseconds. This 2 microsecond is just to clear the trigger pins. And then we are using digital write again for sending a high signal. This will be for a delay of 10 microseconds. After this, we are initializing for each of the pins, and then we get the pin, trigger pin to low as we have already received the signal from as a trigger pin as an input. And so we store this variable in duration 1. For calculating the amount of time, we are using pulse in function only, which will be I. And then for the distance, finding the distance, we are using the duration, the time it took. We are multiplying that by the speed of sound in air, which is 340 meter per second. We are getting that into centimeter. So it will be 0.034, and we only want, we don't want the distance to be doubled as a time is always a double. So we are dividing time by 2, and then we are using, we are doing this for each of the functions. In case if S is equal to pi, then the Arduino will detect and tell the motors to go back. So. And also, going back, there will be a delay of 1000 microseconds, and in which we will store the variable A. So, what variable A does is it will. Okay. In case we don't store variable A, the robot will come back and then it will detect that the flow has come again. So it will start going forward again. So what it what this would do is it will give it a cycle that go back, come, go forward, come back. So we don't want to do that. So in case of our body, where it's like D equal to 1, as the as it has already detected a falling situation of that. So we, now we are doing this that we are putting conditions over here. We are using it. So A equal to 0 and S equal to 0. That means there is pretty much nothing in front of it. So in this case, the motor will be going forward. And if A equal to 1 in this case and S equal to 0, as once the robot comes back, S will S was low there in that case. So in this case, what it will do is it will instruct the motor for the fourth pin to go high and the eighth pin to go low. What this will do is it will make the robot turn towards the left. Towards the right. So it will keep going in the right path instead of going forward, in which there is a stage in front of it. And this loop will instruct the robot to go towards the left in case if there is something at the right. So that's all with the programming. And I will now ask Varad to give specs about all the sensors and voltages. Always be high because the IR pin will be situated just below it and we require an high signal. So what high represents is that the floor is low, and if there is no high signal, if there is low, that means it will detect that there is a staircase in front of you. Yeah, just for example. So it will try to avoid that. So in case mat hila ho jata S is equal to high, then Arduino will detect and tell the motors to go back. So and also for going back, there will be a delay of 1000 microseconds, and in this it will store the variable A. So what variable A does is it will in case if it doesn't store variable A, the robot will come back. And then it will detect that the flow has come again. So it will start going forward again. So what this would do is it will give it a cycle that go back, come, go forward, come back. So we don't want to do that. So in case for our body, where it's like D equal to 1, as it has already detected a falling situation over there. So now we are doing this that we are putting conditions over here. We are using it. So A equal to 0 and S equal to 0. That means there is pretty much nothing in front of it. So in this case the motor will be going forward. And if A equal to 1 in this case and S equal to 0, as once the robot comes back, S was low there in that case. So in this case what it will do is it will instruct the motor for the fourth pin to go high and the eighth pin to go low. What this will do is it will make the robot turn towards the left. Towards the right. So it will keep going in the right path instead of going forward, in which there is a staircase in front of it. And this loop will instruct the robot to go towards the left in case if there is something at the right. So that's all with the programming. And I will now ask Varad to give specs about all the sensors and voltages.
Now I will be explaining the circuit and the specifications of the project. So we have used three ultrasonic sensors. The sensor that we have used is SC-SRO4. One is in the right, one is at the front, and other is at the left hand side. So it will cover all the three directions. And the other sensor that we have used is IR module. So it will detect any staircase that is in the front or if any cliff is there. So it will turn and make the right decisions. So we have used Arduino Pro Mini, which we have connected. And the motor that we have used is N20. So this motor will control The RPM of this motor is 300 repetitions per minute, and it works on 6 volts battery. The other thing that we have is IC, which is L293D, and the function of this IC is that it helps in driving this motor. We are using 2 DC motors, so it will help in running the 2 motors. And the third thing that you can see here is voltage regulator. It will help in minimizing, it will help in controlling the voltage that we send to the circuit. And after that, we have dumped the code inside the Arduino Pro Mini, and it will help in running the program smoothly. So now I'll just show you all the specifications. Other things that we have is 10.4 lithium-ion battery, LM7805 voltage regulator, and caster wheels, and Jarek motor that will be there. So this is our working module, and that's it from my side. Thank you so much.
Okay, so here.